This item didn't quite make it in time for the May mailbag video, but I've got an Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect to play with. We'll take a close look at this board and try out some of the features. There's something pretty interesting about the board that I think we might explore in a future video. But before we get started, I'd like to thank PCBWay for sponsoring the channel. PCBWay offer PCB production, CNC and 3D printing, PCB assembly, and much, much more. They are great to deal with and offer excellent service, quality, and value for money. Check out the link in the description. So let's zoom in on the board and see what we have. We have the main processor, a 32-bit dual-core ARM Cortex M0 Plus processor clocked in at 133 MHz. There's a 16 MB NOR flash chip and a PDM MEMS microphone for audio input. There's also a 6-axis motion controller with a machine learning core. On the output side of things, there's a green LED and there's also an RGB LED. And finally, there's the thing that makes this board interesting, a Nina W102 Wi-Fi and Bluetooth radio module. This module provides connectivity for the RP2040. This, along with the other built-in peripherals, makes this board quite useful. When we plug the board in and start up the Arduino IDE, it immediately prompts us to install the new board. Once we've done that, we can try out some simple examples. So the first thing we'll try is using the RGB LED. Now, one thing to note about this is that the RGB LED is actually connected to the Wi-Fi module, so we need to use the Wi-Fi Nina library to access it. It works pretty nicely. We can do red, green, blue, and any other combination of these that we want. The LED is common anode, so we do need to take the pins low to turn on each colour. We can also read values from the PDM microphone. There's a simple example sketch bundled in with the board that will output values from the microphone to the serial plotter.
Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3.
So that's the Arduino side of things. What about alternatives like Python? Well, there is a release candidate of CircuitPython available. We can download this, and then to get the board into the right mode to be flashed, we just double tap the reset button. Once you've done that, you can just drop the firmware into the new flash drive and it will reboot in CircuitPython mode. I've also dropped a small WAV file onto the flash drive and I've hooked up an I2S amplifier. This simple Python script will play the WAV file. It works pretty well. But why is this board actually interesting? Let's go back to this Nina W102 module. What's amazing about this module is that it actually contains a fully functional ESP32. If we flip the board over, we find there are solder pads that break out the reset, RX, TX and GPIO0 lines. So in theory, you should be able to put the ESP32 into programming mode and burn new firmware into it. So I've soldered some wires to these pads and I've hooked up the RX and TX lines to my USB to UART board. I'm going to use the reset and GPIO0 pads to put the ESP32 into programming mode. Well, eventually I did get this to work. Unfortunately, I've also managed to damage my board and now the RP2040 no longer works. Looking at the schematic, the GPIO0 and the reset lines are connected directly to the RP2040. And I think forcing these low seems to have permanently damaged something. I should have really checked the schematic first to make sure these weren't connected, as it looks like I could have done this programmatically. A valuable lesson learned. I've got some fresh boards ordered, so I'll try these experiments again, but I'm going to be a bit more careful. As always, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please hit the subscribe button. There's more videos in the pipeline. I'll see you in the next video.